So, we talked about how it was important for a pet parent to know about first aid yesterday. Today, it's about identifying the scenarios where you should take your dog to a vet, right? One of the first thing, primary thing that we would encourage is that all pet parents have a primary vet. You cannot be having a pet that, a vet that you keep changing. So have a primary vet and also have a secondary vet. What do I mean by a secondary vet is that there might be scenarios where, your primary vet is not available, that and then you would have to visit. You should not be in a situation where your primary vet is not available and you're trying to find out whom to go next to. Always keep a secondary vet as a backup, just in case for emergencies. But just like humans have family doctors, you should have a family vet that you trust and go to regularly, because when you go to them regularly, they would kind of know your kid's history. So what are the scenarios or the signs that a pet parent should observe to know that, this is when I should take my kids to the vet? So one of the most common signs, and we'll start with paws first, is when you see them chewing their paws a lot. Sometimes it is a sign that the dogs are bored and they have not been exercised enough. But you need to keep watching, checking their paws to see if there is redness inside or some kind of a swelling. If you see something like that, because what happens is when they keep on licking that too much, infection, it can get infected. Small boils, redness can happen. If that happens, take them to a vet. The similar thing happens for the ears. If you find them scratching their ears a lot, and especially if the breed is a kind which has droopy ears, like a beagle, a Saint Bernard, and if they scratch their ears a lot, check the ears to see if there's redness inside. If you see a lot of redness, then obviously you can use green tea and all the other ear cleanser at home, but it'll also be good to kind of go to a vet and have it checked. Other signs to monitor is your dog's or your pet's, your kid's stool, right? If they are normally having good solid stool, it's fine. But sometimes they might have watery stool. If it is only for one or two instances, you're spoiled. Well, I love you. Okay. If it's for a few instances, then it's fine. But if you see that happening for at least a day where they are having watery stool or it is a little darker in shade or even bloodish in shade, then go to a vet and have it checked. A general thing would be just monitor it for a day. Don't go it as soon as they do it, because sometimes pets have bad stomach like humans, right? So it's okay. But if it happens continuous for over a day and a day and a half, then take them to a vet. Okay. The same thing applies for their urine. If the urine is white or yellowish, light yellowish, is fine. Some dogs generally don't tend to drink a lot of water. So in that kind of a scenario, it is fine for them to have yellowish urine. But if it turns to be a lot darker in shade, and if it is for more than a day, then definitely go to a doctor. And finally, if your pet stops eating food, right? Sometimes they feel that their stomach is upset and they won't eat on their own. But if you monitor that it's happening for more than 2 days, right, or a day and a half where they're not eating, not drinking, then try to give them ORS, and human ORS is fine, as much as you can, and take them to a vet because you need to find out what's wrong with them and why they are not eating. So these are the few things as a pet parent you need to watch out for and understand when you should take it to a vet. Obviously, the obvious scenarios where you see a major infection or a major bite wound and all that, that's obvious you will have to take it to the pet and to the vet, sorry. But this kind of signs that we talked about right now are the smaller things that can, if not treated early, can become bigger. So those are the signs to watch out for. Thank you.